Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video session, I am explaining you the concept of asymptotic notations from the topic analysis of algorithms. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the analysis of algorithm. Because before moving to the notations, we must know the concept of analysis of algorithms. So, the analysis of algorithm is nothing but with the help of the algorithms, we are judging the working of the algorithms. This is the criteria to analyze the algorithms. The efficiency of the algorithm depends on time and space complexity. So mainly these are two concepts which are useful to analyze the algorithm, and that efficiency whatever we are going to measure that with the help of asymptotic notations. So analysis of algorithm is can be done with the help of time and space complexity, and to represent that time and space complexity we are going to use the asymptotic notations. Now whenever we are going to analyze the algorithm, we should think about the size of the input. If the size of the input is increased, then we are going to check the performance of the algorithm. Either that performance of the algorithm is going to be increased, or is going to be decreased, or it's going to be neutral. So with the help of size of input, we are going to check the performance of the algorithm. We can't say that the performance of the algorithm will be same for any different types of inputs. So with the increase in the input size, the performance will either be increase, decrease, or can be stable. And that's why the change in performance of the algorithm with the change in number of the input is defined as the asymptotic analysis. And this analysis will help you to analyze the algorithm. Before that, we must know the cases we will supposed to examine. There are basically three cases. They are best case, the worst case, and the average case. These cases are defined with the help of number of instructions are to be executed to get the desired output. So if the fewest number of instructions are executed, then it could be a best case. I would like to give one best example over here. So whenever we want to perform a sorting of the numbers, if the array is already sorted, then time taken by the algorithm will be linear and it requires a less time. So that's why this could be the best case. The second case is worst case, where it will require the highest number of instruction to be executed, and the example is if the array is in reverse order, and the reverse ordered array if I want to sort. For example, if I want to sort a number in ascending order and if input array is in descending order, then this could be a worst case because it will take a maximum time and it will execute the maximum number of instructions from that algorithm. And the third case is nothing but the average case, where average number of instructions are to be executed. When the input array is neither sorted nor in a reverse order, they are generalized and then it will require the average number of instructions. Then let's see the asymptotic notations. They are nothing but the shorthand way to represent the time complexity, and they are represented as the big O notation, omega notation, and the theta notation. Big O notation is represented for the fastest possibility, omega notation is represented by the lowest possibility, and theta notation is represented by the average possibility. Here in this slide, I am going to explain you the comparative study of these asymptotic notation, big O notation, omega notation, and the theta notation. So big O notation is used to represent the upper bound of the algorithm. Omega notation is for lower bound of the algorithm, and this is for the average, that is in between upper and lower bound. The next is longest time computation is done by the big O notation. If I want to represent the shortest time computation required for any algorithm, I will use the omega notation, and for average time I will use the theta notation. And as it is for the longest time, it means that it gives the worst case complexity of an algorithm. The omega notation gives the best case complexity of an algorithm, and for average case complexity it gives we are going to use the theta notation. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel, along with the new videos to understand, to learn the data structure. So happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.